What's up guys and welcome back to my channel. Today, what you are looking at is a Kickstarter project that presents the next level in M.2 SSD enclosures and USB Type-C hubs. This is the Dockcase Explorer Edition M.2 SSD enclosure featuring faster data transfer speeds, hardware protection, and built-in display monitoring features. So up next, we explore its new innovative features and I'll test its data transfer performance in comparison to a legacy enclosure. So that review begins right after this brief intro. So the usage of legacy hard drives is almost non-existent and we are already well advanced in the usage of SATA SSDs and the most recent ultra-high speed M.2 NVMe SSDs. M.2 SSDs were first designed to only work in desktop PCs and laptops, and in the last couple of years, M.2 enclosures emerged providing high-speed portable storage possibilities over legacy flash drives. While this is all well and good for the advancement of storage, one area that is usually overlooked is the health of the SSDs. For those who don't know, even though SSDs can provide lightning data transfer speeds, they have a limited lifespan and can deteriorate in performance over time. So I'm back, and in this purchase, you get the enclosure. A braided 10 gigabits per second USB Type-C to USB Type-C data cable. A screwdriver. A spare screw for securing your SSD. And a user manual. The design of this enclosure is part aluminum, which acts as its heatsink, and the surface consists of tempered glass with an LCD health monitoring screen behind it, the first of its kind. The back panel is secured by one screw and opens up to gain access to the M.2 NVMe slot, which can facilitate 2230, 2242, 2260 and 2280 SSD sizes, and it's compatible with M.2 NVMe type with speeds up to 10 gigabits per second and B and M SATA key types with speeds up to 6 gigabits per second. The top edge has a 10 gigabits per second USB Type-C data port and to the side has a 15 watts USB Type-C power delivery port with a power requirement of 5 volts 3 amps. And the final feature is a button to navigate the menu on the LCD screen. To install your SSD is really simple. Firstly, remove the screw that secures the back panel. Then remove the screw that secures the SSD. Install the SSD into the designated slot. Depending on the size of SSD you are using, secure it using the allotted screw hole. Remove the thin plastic covering the heatpad. And reinstall the back panel. So for this review, I'm using a 1TB Samsung Evo 970 Plus NVMe M.2 SSD, but it can take up to 4TB. Let's have a look at its monitoring features. Firstly, though it's different from regular models, its core hardware is the Realtek 9210 chipset, which is widely used in these adapter boards. Will it have improved transfer rates over legacy models? We'll see in just a moment. It is recommended that you use the included high-speed 10 gigabits per second cable for the best performance, and you can use other cables as well of equal length and rating or higher. For the best transfer rates, it is recommended that you use a USB Type-C 3.2 Generation 2 port. So its built-in LCD display with hardware protection and monitoring features is its primary selling point. Once you plug it in, it will boot up and start by first detecting the SSD you inserted, then allow your PC or mobile device to detect it. on the main screen. The first indicator is a feature called PLP, which stands for Power Loss Protection. This feature, while plugged in, charges a capacitor that holds a charge temporarily for 10 seconds when you eject it from the USB port or suddenly lose power. This protects its electronic components from damage and avoids having to reboot and detect the SSD again. During these 10 seconds, you can reinsert the enclosure without rebooting, and if it's not inserted after 10 seconds, it will automatically shut down. The second item is an identification of the SSD type installed. Here it shows I installed an M.2 1TB NVMe Generation 3x2 Samsung 970 EVO Plus. Below is the health status of the SSD. It gives you its remaining life via a percentage and if it's good or bad. The last feature is my favorite, and that is it detects and displays the type of USB port it's plugged into. Currently, it detects the port is a USB 3.1 with a max transfer speed of 10 gigabits per second. The rating of this USB port, according to the PC's hardware description, is a USB 3.2 Generation 2 port, but it still shows that it's a USB 3.1. What I also like is that it changes color, indicating good or bad status. For the USB type, if it's a USB 2.0, the port will display white. If the port is USB 3.0, it will display blue. And if it's USB 3.1 or 3.2, it will be purple. I have also found that using different types of USB Type-C cables affect how it detects the USB port based on the detected transfer speeds. To navigate its menu, you have to use a combination of long press, double press, single press, and timeouts. To navigate to the next menu, you have to press and hold and allow it to scroll through its various menus and release the button when it lands on the menu you would like to access. So the next menu is SSD information. Here you can see every bit of information about the SSD installed, even down to its serial number, firmware version, and the number of hours it has been in use. The next menu, called About Me, displays its UI version, a barcode to access the Dockcase website information, and the chipset serial number. You have settings to adjust read-only mode, screen saver timer, the option to put it into boot loader mode in the event you have to update the firmware. You can change its language, and you have the option to reset to factory default, to restore, or to reboot. The next menu is the hardware monitor screen. This displays a real-time graph of its current operating temperature and voltage. Here, you can determine if its operating temperature is too high or if its receiving voltage is too low, requiring you to plug in a USB Type-C power source to bring that voltage up to the appropriate level. The last menu is to manually eject and restart the enclosure without unplugging it. This display has the option to change its orientation or screen rotation, as it's sometimes called. This is done by double-clicking the menu button at the home screen. And the final feature is a smart file transfer detection and monitoring feature. What happens is that anytime you transfer files to and from the enclosure, it automatically brings up a screen that displays its live read and write speeds, data read and written disk power session, and the total amount of data read and written over the life of the drive. And for performance over legacy enclosures, I'll do a side-by-side comparison. Please note, to date I have not found an enclosure that has a different chipset from the one used in this enclosure, which is the Realtek 9210. So I expect the recorded transfer speed from the Crystal Disk app will be somewhat similar. Let's have a look. So the Dockcase enclosure has a sequential read speed of 1058 megabytes per second and a write speed of 1043 megabytes per second. It's consistent with all the other models that carry the same Realtek 9210 chipset. And to confirm, here are the results of the other enclosure. So viewers, there you have it. The Dockcase Explorer Edition is the coolest M.2 enclosure ever. It not only looks high-tech, but delivers on performance and protection for your SSDs. It's currently sold on Amazon in three colors, black, pink, and silver, and you can get a $16 coupon off the original price of $89.99 at the time of making this video. But this is not their only product. See the links in the description to check out their other USB Type-C hubs and SSD enclosures. So special thanks to Dockcase for sending their new and innovative product for review. And links in the description are my affiliate links, which means when you click on them to purchase, I earn a small commission that goes towards the upkeep of this channel. So thanks in advance for your support. So give this video the thumbs up, it really helps with the ratings, and ring the notifications bell to be notified each time I release new videos or decide to do a giveaway. Thanks for tuning in, stay connected, and see you in the next one.